You can easily grow a fan base without being signed by a big label or spending money on ads. Today, I'm going to show you how. What's up, Team NBL? I'm Music by Lucas, and for the past 3 years, I've been traveling full-time producing, DJing, speaking, and creating the ultimate website for producers, TeamNBL.com. And as always, one of the first 100 comments is gonna win a free sound bank from my website, TeamNBL.com. Most artists think they need to wait until they have signed tracks, professional profile pic, a great bio, a cool aesthetic, and all the stuff to start their socials that actually just keeps them waiting to start their socials forever. And when they do start their socials, they feel like they need to have a following right away that matches the quality of their music and their aesthetic and their brand. So they end up doing things like joining engagement groups, follow for follow, doing a bunch of ads, or the worst thing, buying followers so that they look legit. These types of strategies not only don't work, but Instagram and other social media algorithms are punishing these types of shortcuts. Here's the good news. You don't need to do any of those types of things, and you don't need to wait forever until you have all that professional stuff to start your socials. All you need to do is follow these simple steps. The first thing you gotta do is think of some things you wanna post. What are going to be your topics and what is going to be your niche? First of all, topics are just things that you want to post about. And it can be harder to do than it sounds because a lot of us just think, okay, I'm going to post about my music, but okay, what about your music? What other stuff are you going to post about? Do you have any hobbies? Do you have any things that you can teach people that they would find valuable? And that really is going to lead you to like, what is your niche? What is your target audience? You really want to have all this kind of stuff line up. You want to have a target audience, which could either be music producers if you're a producer, or it could be other types of people if you have other kinds of hobbies. And then you want to have your niche, which is the stuff within that target audience that you're posting about. Those are your topics. And if you can get all those things to line up, you're on the right track. For example, on my Instagram, my target audience is music producers. My niche is music production within the electronic dance music area. And then my tips, my topics have to do with tips on music production, social media growth, as well as motivation. Once you have your niche and your target audience and you kind of know just some basic ideas of what topics you want to post about, the next thing you really want to do is find reference accounts. Reference accounts are other social media accounts that are posting things that you also want to post similar stuff. Like for example, if you are doing music production tips, you might want to find a few other music production tip accounts, see how they post, see how they break down their captions, see what kind of, are they doing sliders, are they doing reels? All this kind of stuff is really gonna help spark inspiration for you to be able to make your own content. Your goal is to take that inspiration, add your own twist on it. Like for example, let's say you're a naturally funny person, or then maybe you turn maybe a serious tip from somebody else into a more funny and do your twist on it. Or for example, if you're more introverted and you like to type up like longer tip posts, you could take someone's reference post and you could break it down in more detail and you could write down tips step by step and make it more like that. But before you post anything, you need to ask yourself, is your post engaging? This is the number one factor that is gonna help you grow on any social media platform. And what most artists are doing today is they're just trying to post professional content. They're just trying to get a picture up there so they can like, you know, keep their social media profile updated. Maybe it's a cool picture of them looking off into the distance, or maybe it's them in the studio and it says new track coming out this Friday, or whoa, so much support, you know, on the latest track release. Thank you so much, that kind of thing. Which is fine, but the problems with these kind of posts are they're not engaging. They're not going to get, for example, shares, saves, comments, likes, all the kind of engagement, which is really what helps your post grow and reach new followers. Because when Instagram or these other social media platforms algorithms see a lot of engagement on your post, they're going to pitch it organically for free to other types of followers who are similar to your current following, put you on the Explorer page, things like that, which is going to help you really grow. And it's not that you can't post, for example, about that you have a new track coming out, or that you're thankful for all the support, you know, on your new track that just came out. It's how can you take that post and make it engaging? How can you flip it? How can you either ask a question, involve the people who supported you, or involve the other collaborator, or show, like for example, I got a new track coming out next week. Instead of just a picture of you in the studio doing that, what if you gave a little sneak preview, showed some behind the scenes, you know, asked people what they think about the track, really started to kind of make it so it's more engaging. Basically, that's what you want to do. You want to ask yourself before you post, how can you make that post more engaging? Is it engaging enough at this point? Because your goal is to grow and get your posts. Like for example, if you got a new track coming out and you're posting about it, trying to add some hype, your goal is to try to get that post to as many people as possible, right? And the best way to do that is to make it engaging. And once you know your niche, you know your target audience, you know what you want to post about, you've got a few reference accounts, and you have some ideas about how you're going to make your posts engaging, the next step, of course, is to post. But even more importantly, is to be consistent and organized. This is the secret to really growing once you have that engaging content, because you can imagine if you have one cool post that was really engaging and got to a bunch of new followers, imagine how much more you would grow if you could do that more and more often. The more you can post engaging content, the more you can grow. I've made my own social media organization system over the years that's really helped me be able to grow and to organize all my content, and I've made that available to you as well, and I'll leave the link to that below. All right, so now you are making engaging content, you're doing it consistently, you're on a roll. So what are some bonus ways that you can really see a lot of growth? And a big one is collaboration. If you want to get more followers, what's a better way to do that than to introduce yourself to someone else's fan base? It works both ways. It helps you and it helps the other person. So the more you can collaborate, the more you can get in front of more similar audiences, the more you can grow. You can do live streams, you can do track tutorials together, you can do interviews, you can do all kinds of different types of collaboration. And you can start by collabing with people that are at a similar size, maybe a little bit bigger than you, and just work your way up as you keep growing. And you know what? Sometimes you're gonna message them and they're not gonna reply, or they're not gonna be interested, and that's okay, because the more that you collab, the more that other artists and other people will see you collabing with other people, and the more that they're gonna be interested in collabing with you. So when you reach out to them, they're gonna be like, yeah, I saw your collab with that other person, I wanna be involved too. Or they might even reach out to you to collab. And another bonus pro tip is just don't go hard on every social right away. So for example, if you're really just starting and you just wanna figure out a way to be consistent in all this, it's extremely difficult for you to do that across all platforms, across, you know, TikTok, Instagram, Facebook, YouTube. You really wanna kind of put your focus on one or two platforms maybe in the beginning and figure those out before you expand to other platforms. A lot of people think that you can just use the same piece of content, like for example, the same photo or video on every platform, but that's not how it works, because every social media has certain types of content that perform better on that social media than others. So if you post the same piece of content across all platforms, you're gonna have some doing well and others that aren't doing so well. So you're better off figuring out how, you know, just a few of them work and then growing from there. Lastly, give yourself like 30 days of posting consistently before you look at your analytics or worry about your likes or your comments, or really kind of look back at what you've done. A lot of people, I think, they try posting and they do like just a few posts for like a week, and you know, they'll have varying results and they'll just kind of judge themselves right there. First of all, don't judge yourself really at all, because it's always a process. You're always going to be growing. It's never going to be perfect, and that's really the way that you should do it, because you don't really want to add all that pressure and professionalism. You really just want to stay creative, and to stay creative, you want to stay happy, you want to stay in a good place, and that's the best way to do it. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and hit the bell button to be notified about future videos. If you like my tips here, I also have a membership that has helped many artists get signed by top labels. And unlike other memberships that only help you improve your music, me and my team of signed artists, managers, and DJs help you improve your music, grow your socials, build your brand, and manage your career so you can really grow. And now, some more helpful producer tutorials.